All right, so I'll be going over some of the Claude code features that came out in the last 2 weeks, and I'll be going in reverse order from the latest feature to oldest feature. There will be timestamps in the description down below, so you can skip ahead. Basically, getting started, we have customizable status lines over here. So if you run Claude code in whatever folder you're running it in, and you can write slash status line, you can say something like add the weather in London with emojis, press enter over here, and then it will fire off a built-in subagent in Claude code to add this to a status line. And that basically means that just below this like input box over here, it will show whatever information there is. So you can see it proposes edit over here. I can press yes. And then if I exit Claude code and then run Claude code again, and now you can see over here it says London partly cloudy plus 17 degrees. I can add more information to it. So I can say add how long I've been in the session, the model being used, the git branch, the folder name alongside the weather should be last. Press enter and then it will make those changes as well. And now if I press exit over here to close Claude code, and then I run it again, then I should be able to see all these new pieces of information. So you can see it says 0 minutes, Opus 4.1, main, vibe, and then partly cloudy, like this temperature over here. And you can actually see what's happening behind the scenes by going to your home directory over here, pressing Command Shift dot on macOS, and you can see the hidden folders, go to dot cloud. And then you can see a dot settings JSON over here, which calls the bash command for this like bash script. And then you can open up the bash script, press open with cursor, and you can see all this information that Claude has over here. And you can see where it's getting the weather from, which is using this API endpoint over here. And basically you can get Claude to add other things for you. So if you have an API endpoint, you can get it to fetch your emails, for example, like how many unread emails you have. You can get it to fetch like how many dollars you've made so far today on Stripe. And you can just like import like other useful things that may be helpful when you're running a coding session, such as how many tokens you've used so far, or like how many files that you've edited so far, or how many lines that you've changed so far. Anyways, the next thing that you can do is you can run background commands. So you can basically have Claude running and monitoring things in the background. So for example, I can say, can you list the Docker containers I have running and follow the logs of a random container with the dash F? And then it will ask if I want to run this command. I can press enter over here. And now you can see over here says one bash running. So this is running in the background and it's monitoring the output of this Docker container. And I can also say cd into Next.js folder and run npm run dev over here. And then it will start running this as a like background command too. So press yes over here. And now you can see I have two bashes running. And if I write slash bashes over here, I can see the list of bashes, which is the Docker logs over here, the cd over here. I can press enter to view the like what's happening, or I can press K to then kill the like background command. So if I press enter over here, it seems that there's no output available, or I can press K to then kill the like command. And this can be useful because you may have a development server running locally and you want Claude to be able to like see any error logs that end up happening by running its tool bash output. So you don't have to always like copy over the like error logs every single time, for example. The next thing that you can do is you can use at mentions in slash command arguments over here. So for example, if you make a slash command, which is, for example, optimize, I just made this one over here, and this is like a project level slash command, I can do at, and then I can like at a specific folder or file, for example. So I can add this like organization manager.tsx over here, press enter, and then it will only consider this particular file when this slash command is running. They also upgraded the Opus model from 4 to 4.1. They also made it possible to specify which subagent is running which model, and you can watch my video on subagents that I previously made using the link in the description down below. So if you were to write slash agents over here, then run create new agent, for example. And I can describe an agent to be a I18 translator, keep the I18 files in sync, replace the hard-coded strings with the I18 like values, key pairs, press enter over here. And then when making this agent, I can choose whether it's running Sonnet, Opus, or Haiku. And for this particular agent, Haiku makes more sense, like Opus is overkill and so is Sonnet, so I can press Haiku over here. And then if I open the agent file, I can see it says model Haiku over here. Something else I also did is adding hidden files and folders to file search when you use an at mention. So if I write at over here, then I can see .dsstore, which is a hidden file on macOS, .claude.env, and so forth. They also made it possible to at specific agents to invoke them. So I can do at and then run i18n, and I'll see this i18n agent that I just made, and then I can run that particular agent. They also changed one of the commands for transcript mode. So if you don't know already, if you press Control R when an agent is running, then you can see everything that's actually going to Claude. So you can see this bit of code is like going over to Claude and also all these other files as well. And this prompt over here. If you press exit now, rather than interrupting the agent, it just leaves transcript mode. Another small improvement that I found useful is on macOS, you can do Control V images. So if you run Command Shift 4 on macOS, you can take a screenshot like this, and then you can press Command V into Claude Code over here, and then the image easily goes there. So previously on macOS, you would just have to drag and drop images into the like terminal when Claude Code is running. Now you can just paste them. They also added support for reading PDF files, so you can drag and drop a PDF file into Claude Code, and then just say, summarize this, for example, and then it will like let you know everything that's on the PDF file. And that can be pretty useful for some people, because you may be given a feature spec in like a PDF file or something from your products manager, and you can just put that into Claude Code. And one more thing they added is allowing you to specify which model is used with which slash command. So for example, if you go to your commands folder over here, I have an optimized command. I can change this to use Opus, for example. So at the very top, if I write this over here, I can write model, and then I can just change this to Opus, for example. So for some commands, you may want to use more powerful models. Other commands is kind of overkill, and you don't want to eat up all your context or use too many tokens, and you can use simpler commands instead. And yeah, that was basically every new thing that was added to Claude Code in the last 2 to 3 weeks. If you have found this video useful, then do subscribe, because I will be making another one like this 2 to 3 weeks from now.